Now I'm going to talk on free radicals and antioxidants. So this is very important chapter. You should understand to know many things about the development of diseases. Okay. So if you see the definition of free radical is a molecule or molecular fragment that contains one or more unpaired electrons, in its outer orbits, So, free radical is a molecule or a molecular fragment that contains one or more unpaired electrons in its outer orbits, So one or more unpaired electrons. Unpaired electron means single electron. See, this is paired electrons. Two electrons are there. Here also two electrons are there. So this B, if you see the B, so this is two, paired electron, But here if you see, one electron has been removed from this atom or molecule. So it has become free radical. So this is a free radical. So B, you can see in the B there is a loss of one electron, so this is called as free radical. And C, if you see what happens, see here also there is one single unpaired electron, so this is also a free radical with an unpaired electron, so free radical means it is a molecule or molecular fragment that contains one or more unpaired electrons in its outer orbits. It contains one or more unpaired electrons, in its outer orbit. If you see the characteristics of free radicals initiate autocatalytic reactions. Molecules that react with free radicals are in turn converted to free radicals. Like you can see in some comic serials and all, or in some movies and all, they see the ghost will if somebody will go and fight with the ghost, and they also will become like ghost. You can see in horror movies and all these kind of situations. So ghost, the one who want to go and fight with the ghost, they also will become like ghost. So free radicals are like that. So free radicals are the molecules which go to react with free radicals, they become free radicals. So what we can say is free radicals beget free radicals. So it is like that. So they are unstable. These free radicals are unstable, very reactive, and short-lived. Free radicals, they are unstable, very reactive, and short-lived. As they tend to catch an electron from other molecules. So they are unstable, very reactive, and short-lived, as they tend to catch an electron from other molecule. Free radicals cause damage to biomolecules like DNA, RNA, proteins, etc. In cells and tissues. So free radicals can cause damage to biomolecules like DNA, RNA, proteins, etc. in cells and tissues. Free radicals conventionally represented by superscript dot. So let's say this is a compound with a one dot is represented, means this is a free radical. So free radicals are conventionally represented by a superscript dot. So body, you know that there is oxygen. Oxygen is carried by the hemoglobin in the blood to the various tissues. So when you see the fate of oxygen in the body, this is required for electron transport chain. So oxidase enzymes, they use this oxygen in electron transport chain. This is required for monooxygenase enzymes, dioxygenases, and oxygen is responsible for the formation of free radicals in the body. So if you see the fate of oxygen, oxygen is both necessary and toxic to the human life. Oxygen is both necessary and toxic to human life. Whatever we are breathing, you know that it is a oxygen. We are breathing the oxygen that is present in the atmosphere. But this oxygen, when you take in pure concentration, it is toxic to the body. Even those who are there in the ICU also, they will not give pure oxygen. Pure oxygen is always toxic to the body. So they mix up with some amount of nitrogen and other gases, then they will give this oxygen for the ICU patients also. Those who are on ventilator or those who are on not able to breathe themselves for external assistance and all, they are giving oxygen, means it is not pure oxygen. It is a mixed oxygen they will give, mixed with some other gas. Like nitrogen and other gases, they will mix and then they give. So pure oxygen is toxic to the body. So this is oxygen is necessary and toxic to human life. So oxygen is mainly utilized for cellular respiration, mainly used for cellular respiration. Cellular respiration means oxidative phosphorylation, is also called as electron transport chain. So in oxidative phosphorylation, what happens, this oxygen accepts electrons from reduced nucleotides, like NADH and FADH. These are called reduced nucleotides, and they donate electrons to the oxygen. Okay, so this process is coupled with the formation of ATP. So this takes place in electron transport chain. So oxygen is required in electron transport chain for oxidative phosphorylation. This process is called cellular respiration. So through electron transport chain only, ATP is formed in mitochondria. So oxygen is required in electron transport chain or oxidative phosphorylation. Some amount of oxygen is utilized by the enzymes like oxidases and oxygenases. Monooxygenase and dioxygenase. These enzymes are important for catabolism of amino acids. Detoxification of drugs and synthesis of steroids. These enzymes are important for catabolism of amino acids, detoxification of drugs and synthesis of steroid compounds. So oxygen is required by some enzymes like monooxygenase and dioxygenase. And oxygen is responsible for the formation of free radicals called as reactive oxygen species, ROS. ROS means reactive oxygen species. So oxygen is a biradical in nature. Oxygen is biradical in nature. It has tendency to form reactive oxygen species. Through one electron reduction. Then these reactive oxygen species, they are constantly being formed through normal metabolic pathways. So reactive oxygen species, they are produced in the metabolism, during the metabolism. So this is how another possibility of formation of reactive oxygen species. Now most of the time they are removed by scavenging system. So our body has got some scavenging system, so to collect these free radicals. Because free radicals, I told you, the main property of free radical is free radicals B get free radicals. Or whichever molecule goes and reacts with free radical, that will also become a free radical. So this is very dangerous. So that is the reason these free radicals are removed by the body by scavenging system. So only when an imbalance occurs, they initiate free radical chain reaction. So when the imbalance occurs in the scavenging system, then these free radicals, what they do, they initiate free radical chain reaction. Chain reaction means continuously it will disturb all the molecules in the body, so everything will become free radical and they can cause damage to the cellular components. So if everything is becoming free radical, what will happen? It will cause damage to the cellular components. Now enzymes such as oxidases like cytochrome oxidase, oxygenases like monooxygenase enzyme, then cytochrome P450 enzyme, dioxygenases like lipoxygenase, lipoxygenase, okay, all incorporate oxygen into substrate and use it. So enzymes such as oxidases, oxygenases and monooxygenase or dioxygenase, lipoxygenase, they use this oxygen as substrate. They use oxygen in the reactions as substrate. So you can see here, this oxidase enzyme is using oxygen and reduces it to hydrogen peroxide. Okay, monooxygenase, if you see oxygen and XH2, it becomes oxygen is incorporated with hydrogen and results in the formation of water. Dioxygenases, they results in the formation of SO2. Okay, so monooxygenase means see only one oxygen is incorporated. Dioxygenases means they are incorporating the oxygen molecules. Two oxygen atoms are incorporated with the substrate. So this is how oxygen is utilized in the body for various reactions by various enzymes and reducing substances. So most common free radicals are reactive oxygen species and reactive nitrogen species. Reactive nitrogen species. So reactive oxygen species and reactive nitrogen species are called are the most free radicals that are produced in the human body. Now if you see superoxide, this is a superoxide, the O2 minus, it is called O2 minus. O2 minus is a superoxide radical, free radical. Hydroxyl radical, OH minus. Hydroperoxyl radical, HO2 minus. HO2 minus is hydroperoxyl radical. Peroxyl radical, RO2 minus. Okay. Alkoxyl, RO minus. Carbonate, CO3 minus. Chlorine, Cl minus. Nitric oxide, NO. This is reactive nitrogen species. All others, if you see, these are all reactive oxygen species because they contain oxygen in their structure. Because of oxygen, they become free radical. And certain non-radical molecules have been included in this definition. Like these are oxidizing agents or molecules that can be easily converted into free radicals. Let's say singlet oxygen. Singlet oxygen can be easily converted to free radical. Then hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is also can become a free radical easily. Hypochlorous acid, HOCl. Hypochlorous acid is also able to form free radicals. Then hypobromous acid, ozone, O3. Ozone is also able to form free radicals. Then peroxynitrite. Peroxynitrite means ONOO-. So all these things are non-radical molecules, but these are also can be considered as free radicals because these are oxidizing agents or molecules that can be easily converted into radicals. Actually, these are not free radicals as you see, but immediately on oxidation, these agents, they develop into free radicals. That is why these substances are also considered as free radical molecules. Now if you see the reactive oxygen species, of the oxygen metabolites produced, O2 minus is superoxide, OH minus is hydroxyl radical or free radicals. These free radicals along with hydrogen peroxide H2O2 are collectively referred as react to oxygen species. These free radicals along with H2O2 are collectively referred to as reactive oxygen species. Hydrogen peroxide is included because it readily forms a hydroxyl radical. So this is also considered as reactive oxygen species. Now see, this is oxygen, molecular oxygen. By the addition of one electron, it will become O2 minus. This O2 minus, by the addition of H plus ions, it will become H2O2. And hydrogen peroxide, by the addition of one more, by the addition of one electron and removal of proton, what will happen? This will become OH minus. This is a free radical. Then again OH minus, with addition of one more electron, it becomes H2O. So it becomes water. So likewise, this hydrogen peroxide is able to form the free radicals. This is also considered as reactive oxygen species. Now here I have given some more examples and the corresponding antioxidant. Antioxidant means this is a substance which can quench the reaction of hydrogen, reaction of free radicals. Antioxidants are able to quench the reactions catalyzed by free radicals. So they are called as antioxidants. They protect the body from the free radicals. So reactive oxygen species, O2 minus is a superoxide radical. O2 minus is superoxide radical. OH minus is hydroxyl free radical. Hydroxyl free radical. So this can be quenched by the antioxidant like superoxide dismutase, vitamin E and beta carotene in the body. Beta carotene, vitamin E and superoxide dismutases are able to quench the hydroxyl free radical. So these are acting as antioxidants for hydroxyl radical. Then RO minus, alkoxyl free radical. RO minus is alkoxyl free radical. ROO minus, peroxyl free radical. This peroxyl free radical can be quenched by vitamin E and vitamin C. Then H2O2 hydrogen peroxide is catalyzed, protected by catalase and glutathione peroxidase. Catalyzed by catalase and glutathione peroxidase. LOO minus is lipid peroxide, peroxides. This is protected by glutathione peroxidase enzyme as acts as antioxidant. So glutathione peroxidase, catalase, vitamin E, vitamin C, beta carotene, superoxide dismutase, they all act as antioxidants by quenching. Quenching means it stops the free radicals in the body and they stop the chain reaction also. So they protect the body from the adverse effects caused by the reactive oxygen species in the body. So there are many possible ways are there for the formation of free radicals in the body. So if you see the air pollution, if the air is polluted, what will happen? The air consists of lot of industrial waste. Industries are releasing lot of toxic substances in the form of smoke into the atmosphere. So that consists of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide and other hydrocarbon gases will be there. So these, they reduce the oxygen. What they do, they react with the atmospheric oxygen and they convert the, they pollute the oxygen present in the atmosphere. And even they result in the formation of ozone also. So when you inhale such kind of damaged air, what will happen? These toxic substances through the air can enter into our body through respiratory system and they settle in the body and they may be responsible for the damage of DNA present in our cells, which can cause the production of free radicals, can cause damage to the DNA and they may lead to severe effects in the body. And in the WBC cells, if you see, they need oxygen. WBC cells, they need oxygen for scavenging action. In the mitochondria, there is production of OH minus hydroxyl radical, and UV light coming from the sun, when it reacts with the oxygen, it converts, ionizes this oxygen and it makes O2 minus, OH minus, nitrogen oxide, nitrous oxide or the gases that are produced. So they can cause such kind of radicals, when we breathe, they may cause DNA damage and can lead to severe diseases development in the body. Smoking also, cigarette smoking also can lead to the development of the formation of free radicals, which can harm our body by affecting the DNA. And radiation like X-rays, gamma rays, beta rays, alpha rays, these are ionizing radiation. When these ionizing radiations, our body is exposed to ionizing radiation, then also what will happen? There is ionization of the substances. Ionization of the substances will take place. Then they may develop in the more number of free radical formation in the body. So this is how, by polluted air, by cigarette smoking, by exposing to the radiation, radiating substances like cosmic rays, beta rays, cathode rays, X-rays and all. Then UV radiation comes from oxygen, comes from sun also, can produce the, ionize the oxygen which is present in the atmosphere. Then the mitochondria in oxidative phosphorylation results in the formation of oxygen radicals, hydrogen, hydroxyl radicals. Then the WBC cells, which are using the oxygen for scavenging system, also may be responsible for free radical formation. So this is how free radicals are produced in the body. Free radicals are produced in the